This book is called Fractioned Fun, written by David A. Adler and illustrated by Nancy Tobin. A fraction is a part of something. We use fractions all the time. When someone says she is 8.5 years old, she is using a fraction. She is saying that she is a fraction, a part of a year, more than 8. When you share a granola bar with a friend, you are using fractions too. Each of you is getting only a fraction, a part of the bar. Each time you eat a slice of pizza, you are eating a fraction, a part of the pie. Most often, pizza pies are cut into 8 slices, into 8 equal parts. Each slice is one of those 8 equal parts. Each slice is 1/8 of the pie. If you eat 1 slice, you are eating 1/8 of the pie. If you eat 2 slices, you are eating 2/8 of the pie. You are eating 2 of 8 equal parts. In the fraction 1/8, the top number, the 1, is the numerator. The bottom number is the denominator. Each fraction has a numerator and a denominator, a top number and a bottom number. Now let's do some pizza math. It will teach you about fractions. To do pizza math, you will need 3 paper plates, all the same size, a pencil, a ruler, and red, green, and blue crayons. With the pencil, mark the center of each plate. Using the ruler, draw a straight line through the mark from one edge of the plate to the other. The lines you drew divided each plate into 2 equal parts. Each part is 1/2 of the plate. If on your plate one part is larger than the other, it is probably because your marks were not in the exact centers of the plates. On one plate, write 1/2 in each of the 2 parts. With the red crayon, shade in one part, 1/2 of the plate. On another plate, draw a second line from one edge to the other and through the center mark. Draw it so that you divide the plate into 4 equal parts. Each part is 1/4 of the plate. Write 1/4 in each of the 4 parts of the plate. With the red crayon, shade in one part, 1/4 of the plate. On the third plate, draw a second line through the center of the plate, dividing it into 4 equal parts. Next, draw 2 more lines through the center of the plate, dividing it into a total of 8 equal parts. Each part is 1/8 of the plate. Write 1/8 in each of the 8 parts of the plate. With the red crayon, shade in one part, 1/8 of the plate. Now look at the 3 plates. Pretend each of the plates is a pizza pie. Which slice is the largest? 1/2, 1/4, or 1/8? Which slice is the smallest? What happens to a fraction as the denominator, the bottom number, changes? As the denominator gets larger, the fraction gets smaller. As you cut the pie into more and more slices, each pizza slice gets smaller and smaller. With the green crayon, shade in two sections of the third plate. The two sections should be next to each other. You have shaded in 2/8 of the plate. With the blue crayon, shade in three sections of the third plate. The three sections should be next to each other. You have shaded in 3/8 of the plate. If you pretend that the plate is a pizza pie, it's clear that there is more pizza in the blue section than the green section, and more in the green than in the red. 3/8 is more than 2/8 or 1/8. 2/8 is more than 1/8. What happens to a fraction as the numerator, the top number, gets larger? As the numerator gets larger, the fraction gets larger. Now that you know about fractions, you can find the weight of some things that weigh almost nothing at all. You can find the weight of a penny, a nickel, or a dime. To weigh them, you will need a scale, like a diet or postage scale, a scale that will register as little as 1 ounce. You will also need a lot of pennies, nickels, and dimes. How much does a penny weigh? If you put one penny on the scale, it seems to weigh nothing at all. Add a penny. Keep adding pennies until the scale registers 1 ounce. How many pennies did it take? Take the pennies off the scale and do the same thing with nickels. Take the nickels off the scale and do the same thing with dimes. How much does each penny, nickel, or dime weigh? On my scale, 11 pennies together weighed 1 ounce. Each penny weighs 1/11 of an ounce. 6 nickels weighed 1 ounce. Each nickel weighs 1/6 of an ounce. 13 dimes weighed 1 ounce. Each dime weighs 1/13 of an ounce. Which coin weighs the most? The nickel is the heaviest of the three coins. The smaller the bottom number of a fraction, the denominator, the larger the fraction. 1/6 is more than 1/11 or 1/13. Which coin weighs the least? The dime is the lightest coin. The larger the bottom number of a fraction, the denominator, the smaller the fraction. 1/13 is less than 1/11. Or 1/6. Now get some tissues, envelopes, and pencils. How much does each tissue weigh? If you put just one tissue on the scale, it seems to weigh nothing at all. Keep adding tissues until the scale registers 1 ounce. How many tissues together weigh 1 ounce? That number is your denominator. How much does each tissue weigh? How much does each envelope weigh? How much does each pencil weigh? Which weighs the most, a tissue, an envelope, or a pencil? Which weighs the least? Sometimes it's hard to tell if one fraction is more or less than another. Sometimes, even though two fractions look different with different numerators and denominators, they are really the same. To learn about fractions that look different but are really the same, you will need graph paper, a pencil, a ruler, and a crayon. Using your ruler, draw three rectangles on the graph paper. Make each rectangle the same size, 4 boxes long and 2 boxes wide. Divide the first rectangle into 2 equal parts, into halves. With a crayon, shade in half of the first rectangle. Divide the second rectangle into 4 equal parts, fourths. Shade in 2/4 of the second rectangle. Divide the third rectangle into 8 equal parts, eighths. Shade in 4/8 of the third rectangle. Compare the shaded sections of each rectangle. They should look the same. Half, 2/4, and 4/8 are equal fractions. Coins can also teach you about fractions. There are 4 quarters in a dollar. Each quarter is 1/4 of a dollar. There are 20 nickels in a dollar. Each nickel is 1/20 of a dollar. There are 100 pennies in a dollar. Each penny is 1/100 of a dollar. 1/4 is 1/4 of a dollar. It's 25 cents. 5 nickels are 5/20 of a dollar. They're 25 cents. 25 pennies are 25/100 of a dollar. They're 25 cents too. 1/4, 5/20, 25/100 are equal fractions. There are lots of other equal fractions. Now that you know about fractions, start looking for them. When a glass is only partly filled with juice, only a fraction of the glass is filled. When you have read one of many chapters in a book, you have read only a part, just a fraction of the book. Keep on the lookout for fractions. They're everywhere.